Hey everyone! Welcome to Active Galactic Videos. My name is Taylor and today I will be bringing you 5 facts about the Juno mission in under 5 minutes. So let's get started! Juno won't be the first spacecraft to reach Jupiter. A total of 8 spacecrafts have at least flown by Jupiter as part of their missions. The Galileo spacecraft was the first to study Jupiter from orbit in 1995. It studied Jupiter for over 7 years, and during its time in orbit, it was able to study the planet's composition and atmosphere. And now, Juno will enter Jupiter's orbit and hopefully answer all the questions previous spacecrafts left us with. Juno will map out the gravitational and magnetic fields of Jupiter. It will accomplish this by using its onboard magnetometer and radio receiver. These allow us Earthlings down here to determine what might actually lie underneath the cloudy, gaseous atmosphere of Jupiter. We should be able to tell whether or not Jupiter has a solid core at its center, and with any luck, what it's made out of. Juno was launched on an Atlas V rocket. Because the funding for space missions is so tight and going to space is extremely expensive, it wasn't in the budget to build a brand new rocket just for Juno. Luckily, the Atlas V has a perfect launch record. And even though it's a great rocket, it's not powerful enough alone to get Juno all the way to Jupiter. Back in 2013, Juno performed a successful flyby of Earth. Juno used Earth's gravity as a kind of slingshot to help increase its velocity, giving it the boost it needed to get it all the way to Jupiter. Knowing more about the composition of Jupiter's atmosphere will tell us a little bit more about what our solar system was like when it was still forming. Juno was equipped with infrared cameras and radiometers. These devices are going to penetrate hundreds of kilometers down into the clouds of Jupiter, giving us an indication of how much oxygen is in the atmosphere. This will tell us how much water is in Jupiter's atmosphere. The amount of water in Jupiter's atmosphere will either confirm or disprove our current theories about the formation of the solar system. So, funny story. Jupiter got its name from Roman mythology. Jupiter is the king of the gods, and each one of its 4 largest moons, also known as the Galilean moons, are all named after one of Jupiter's lovers. But none are named after his wife. One myth tells of Jupiter enshrouding himself in clouds to hide his mischievous behavior, but his wife Juno was suspicious, and she broke through the clouds to see what he was up to. Now, the Juno spacecraft is about to peer through the clouds of Jupiter to see what's going on. Thank you for watching our videos, everyone. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. This video is part of our Jupiter Week series, so make sure to check out the other videos about Jupiter and the Juno mission. Bye!